Yo, what is up, everyone? Welcome to my channel. Sorry, let me fix everything up here right now. Make sure you guys can see what I'm going to do. Alright, so today I'm going to work on something. I'm going to use some different paints this time. These paints I actually bought at Sam's when I want to say like a couple months ago. And until today, I'm going to use them. Why? Because I have nothing else to do. So, I think I know what I'm going to do in this little background. So this is a canvas that I thought on this stuff, but, you know, I like what Bob Ross would say. There's never a mistake. There's always happy accidents. So, I think I have an idea. So, let's hope it would actually work. If not, then for the next video, I promise it will be something better. But let's get into the video, shall we? So, I need the color black if I can find it. And I found it. So, these are 0.32 full ounces. So this is not a lot of paint, to be honest, but I mean, if you like to paint, you know how to maintain your paint or whatever. You understand what I'm trying to say. So they have this little thing in the cap. Oops. Right here in the cap. And you press on it and then it opens, because right now it was closed. So, that's what I did. So, what I'm going to do is with a pencil, I'm going to neatly or softly draw what I'm going to be doing. This has to be a video, well, a cartoon that I watched a lot, and I've really, really enjoyed it when I was really young, and I was very, very sad when it was done with. I was like, no. So, I love to draw. I really love to draw. I've been drawing since I was very little, like in high school. A lot of people would always tell me why didn't I go to art school and stuff like that. It was always the money for me. You know, being here, it's not that easy just to say, oh, I want to go here. It's always like, do we have enough money for it? I would always think about my parents first. It's very hard trying to do something that you love, but knowing you really can't because you're being considerate of your family, but at the same time, I know you gotta do something. Sometimes you gotta do what you think is right, right? My parents were very supportive of me, of my painting and my drawing. I would paint their table with what I didn't really understand, because I really have no idea what I was doing when I was younger. I would use oil paint, and sadly got it all over their nice table. I was going berserk because I did not know how to take it off. And until this day, I think it is still there. And every single time I see it, I'm like, that's the time that I messed up there. Their table. So if you guys already see what I'm doing, I'm going to be doing Courage the Cowardly Dog. I always love dogs. Dogs are a girl's best friend, a guy's best friend, everybody. And, well, I just really enjoy Courage. So I am done with my outline. I think I did it way too hard, but like I said, later on I'm just gonna do it better. So what I usually do is I either put paint on my hand, or I'll just get paint from it. This is a 1 Master's Touch Fine Art Studio brush. These are from the really tiny little canvases. I have a little tiny canvas right here. I actually made 2 of them, and I was very proud of it. See something. One eyebrow is a lot bigger and the other one is a lot fatter and shorter, so try to fix that as I can at the moment. Also, something that I also like to use is this Golden Artist Colors Acrylic Glazing Liquid Gloss. So what it does for me is, like it says, acrylic medium used to extend the working time of acrylic paintings. As a lot of you may already know, acrylic paint dries really very quickly. Sometimes I do not want it to dry very quickly. So what I do is I put this, that way I can even use whatever I have here, I can use it more. I don't really like to waste a lot of paint, so if I have the opportunity not to waste paint, I will use this, of course. And, back to my story when I was a little kid, I would beg my parents for journals, drawing paper, everything, and thankfully they would buy it for me. I mean, I think I had maybe 7 art books, and now I have no idea what is done with them. They're probably already in the trash, I don't even know, which is sad because I actually wanted to redraw some of the things that I've done when I was very young. I wanted to actually do now, because I mean, from that time to now, I feel like I have grown as an artist. I started liking it a little bit more, like drawing more. Painting not as much. So when I was little, I did not like to paint or color. Everything was black and white. I was scared of color. I was scared of everything. I did not want to touch color. Nothing. Especially when it was like school stuff and I had to use color. That would be like the worst thing ever for me. I would always think that I wasn't good enough, that everybody else's work looks better. And I think that's one thing that I did really wrong, is I'm like, oh, it doesn't look like theirs, oh, mine doesn't look perfect. Of course mine's not gonna look perfect, mine's not gonna look the same as the other people. And after I got in a little competition school when I was very little, up in, I want to say like in elementary, which was what, middle school? Yeah, it was middle school. I entered a contest and I did a
seahorse. Oh, I was beyond ecstatic from what I did. That was the most amazingest thing I've ever done. So, and then after I got a medal, not even a medal, like a little ribbon for like first place, I wanted to do more and more and more and more and more and more. And like that was one of the reasons why I wanted to keep going, because I felt like I did what I could, and it was good.
Oh crap. It was
so incredible. So yeah, it's not gonna be easy. It's not ever gonna be easy. You have to learn from your mistakes. First time I ever used acrylic or oil painting, I was making, Mario. I was making a canvas of Mario. And I did not know like the difference between oil painting, acrylic painting. I just knew watercolor, because I mean, who doesn't know about watercolor, right? So I used oil painting and I thought it was already dried. Like, okay, I finished, it's gonna dry up, I'm ready. So I sit it on my bed, because at the time I did not have a little art table. And I sat on it and I ruined my pants. So now I just have pants just for art. I have my art pants. Which was one of the most funniest moments of my life. Because I was like, what's happening? What have I done? I ruined my pants. Oops, sorry. As you can see, I've done other paintings, done that for my nieces. They did not take it because they don't want to make holes in their house, but that is hers and she already knows it too. So now I think I'm gonna use some white for the eyes. I don't like this white already. This white is just not out there. It's not like, boom, I'm here. This white is like, oh, yeah, I'm here. Let me start working on it. Blah, blah, blah. I do not like this. I'd rather use my white acrylic painting from like the ones I always buy, but not this. This is not something I like. This white is just very sad. And you know, I wanted to start my YouTube channel because I wanted to help out my parents first. Because my parents, like any other parent, does whatever they can in the world in order for us to succeed and not have a hard time like they have when they were younger. Oh, so now we're going to use color orchid.
Oh no!
Orchid. Oh. Hopefully orchid. It's going to be good enough. And I mean, there's still a lot of things that I need to learn about coloring and painting and stuff like that. A lot to learn about. I just want to learn my way, you know? I want to be like, yeah, I tried it, did not work. Okay, let me try to find something else. Use a lot of Prisma colors as well, and I use Faber-Castell's, and I'll be showing. showing you guys more videos of me painting and coloring and with markers. I think my favorite one is markers. I like drawing and painting with the markers.
We have to play our best.
I like Copic markers and Prismacolors.
Actually,
you
know what, that guy's got 13 kids.
Some, not all of them, but some Winsor & Newton.
Oh yeah. It's almost like he's playing with mouse.
But I want to give one Arteza a shot. But I wonder when. I've heard a lot of reviews on them, and they all sound like very positive stuff, so that's something I actually want to try one day, and hopefully, I'm still around to show you guys what I learned about Tisa. So that's that. I mean, it actually looks pretty good. Not as good as other colors, but I mean, that's what we get when it comes to Sam's, right? I wanted to use blue violet, but it does not look like okay. Okay, so I'm gonna use violet again. Kind of want to give it a time to dry, but. Use his little nosy nose on the little dry areas. You can see it actually looks a little bit better with the violet on. I usually put a light color and then a dark color when it comes to painting sometimes, but sometimes you want to go with a color gray and then work your way up with color. But I mean, I think that's every artist has their own way. This is just my way of the way that I think it makes it look better. I'm not saying my way is the right way, but this is the way that I feel comfortable in. If you have your own way, you keep doing what you're doing, and you should be fine. But it's just another way you can do it. Sometimes I go over the black because it's easier for me to go over again with black than with these colors again, so I don't worry about it as much. Maybe I can go over white again, and maybe the white can go a little bit darker. It can pop up a little more because I'm still not happy with this white. So I'm done with that. I guess we're almost done, right?
I
guess we're almost done. So, put some white. It's a little bit better. It's a little bit brighter. I could see a little bit more white than the background.
I'm so bad.
I mean, don't get me wrong, the background's a bit dark for what I'm doing, but we're okay. We're okay.
Yeah, of course.
And I think after this, I'm almost done. Who here has watched Courage and loved Courage? Courage was my favorite. I always felt bad and so sad when you used to call him names. It would always make me feel really sad. I'm gonna give him a little bit of shine in the nose, though. I'm gonna give him a little shine and bright. So we got that. Now, if I can find the black, found it. I can go over some of this while this white dries. Because I need to go over blue, actually, so it can look a little bit better. See how what I mean is I just go over the black you'll burn it up. Like, you can actually see it a little bit better. That's why some of that already mind going over. Like the hands, so over the hands. Well, just let me know, guys, what do you want me to do next for my next video? I'm thinking I'm going to be doing some kind of anime. I really love Seven Deadly Sins, and I've been working on something. I've been working on it, and I'm going to give you a little sneak peek of what I'm doing, and I will show you the rest later. When I'm actually done with it. So, with this one, I am done. I'm just gonna give him some little blue little veins on his eyeballs because he has bull eyes eyeballs.
So, I recorded 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I recorded 5 videos so far.
I like to talk and sing in my head. So I'm just like when I'm drawing and painting, I'm really, really like to listen to music. But sometimes I like to pat it down, make it go a little bit not too heavy on the blue. There you got it. There is Courage, the Cardi Dog Show. Starting Courage, the Cardi Dog. Well, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. And please, guys, let me know what you want me to do next. Maybe next time I can do something else that you guys, whatever you want, just let me know. And I'm going to try my best to make it look good. So, yeah, please give it a thumbs up, a like, and subscribe. And let me show you what I'm making about Seven Deadly Sins. I'm not done yet, but I'm working on it. Again, please subscribe, comment down below. Thank you for watching.